Hi, welcome in this new video in the How Do I series of Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. This video will be about emphasizing data by using colors and icons. I'm Erik Wouters, or Waldo. I'm a Dynamics NAV MVP and I'm creating this video for you in collaboration with Platan. At the end of this video, you will be able to give more meaning to the data that is shown in the page in Dynamics NAV. And we will do that by using colors and icons. I will explain this in four steps. Let's first give you an intro on the coloring part. Now here you see the default contact list, and you already see that some data in the contact list has been emphasized. Namely, all the companies are emphasized by making it bold. Now how is this done? Let's look at the contact list in the development environment. When we go to the number field, you'll see that there are two properties that makes this possible. First of all, there is a style property where you indicate what style you want this field in. Like now it is strong, and strong apparently means that it's going to be bold. And you've got a style expression. Style is strong is a variable which is just a Boolean. And this is used or filled in the onAfterGet record trigger. So here you have when the type is a company, then I want my style to be strong, which actually just means all this bold data are companies. And you can clearly see by emphasizing the data, which are all my companies in my contact list. Now, one thing that is very important and I didn't mention is this. You noticed that I used a variable here. The style is strong because it can be a company or not. So this has to be true or not. So I'm filling a property with some kind of variable. To be able to do that, I have to send this variable to the dataset as well. And I do that by including this variable into the dataset. So I have to set this property. Now we use the style strong, but there are different styles. Here is a list of all the styles you can use. And you can see the different styles have a different coloring and layout. Like attention is going to be italic as well, not only red. The unfavorable is going to be red, bold, and italic. And so you see, you can work with different coloring. Now what we just saw is actually making something strong or not. But it would be more useful to have different types of coloring to the same dataset. Now let's do that by an example. Now in a way, I want to be able to create a function like this. A getStyle function, where this is just an example. When the balance is far too high, I want to make my coloring unfavorable. When it is a little bit too high, I want to make it ambiguous. And when not all my mandatory fields are filled in, I want to raise some attention to it. So I make it the style attention. And when all of these three doesn't apply, I just don't want to apply any style. Now let's try to use this. I did that on a customer table, so I'm going to try to apply this on a customer list. The first thing I'll do is create a variable. And as I said, I have to include this variable into the dataset because my role tailor client has to be aware of the value of this variable. Next, I'm going to apply this variable. And the first thing I would do is apply that into the style, but that is not possible because I can only select some kind of style here. In fact, I'm not doing anything with this. I'm going to apply the variable into the style expression. And then the only thing I need to do is fill my variable on AfterGetRecord. And I'm using my function on my table. Now let's go to my customer list and you'll see that the coloring kicks in. And I've got some ambiguous records. I've got some records that need some attention. Apparently not all mandatory fields are filled in for these ones. And I've got some very unfavorable records, which are customers that have far too high balance. And by doing this, you see that I can raise some attention, different types of attention to different records in the customer table. Now we all know a picture is worth 1,000 words. So maybe we can emphasize data by using pictures or icons. Let's see how we can do that. Now, in the default application, icons hasn't been used at all. In fact, we have pictures in the company information table or at the item table, but that's it. Maybe we can steal some ideas from that. So if we go to the company information, you'll see there is a picture. How is this displayed? Well, very simple. The field is a blob field. A blob field of the subtype, a bitmap, where we indicate that there is going to be a picture in this blob field. And it is displayed in the company information by just adding it as a field. If we can use this in some kind of list page, then we will be able to add pictures to records and give some meaning to it. Now, before we can do this, we probably need some kind of library with icons that we can use. So I prepared an icon table, which has some kind of code and also that blob field that we needed. And I filled this icon table with some pictures. And here you can immediately see that I can use icons or pictures in a grid layout as well. And this we can use to add some meanings to our records and to emphasize data. Now, I created this table because I need a collection of icons. I have to be able to use some kind of blob to attach to some kind of record, to emphasize that record. Now we know how it works, and we have prepared our library of icons. So let's use that. Use that in a sales order list where we want to indicate that orders are released and ready to post. Now the first thing we need is our blob field in our table. Now I created the status icon field as a blob, and I indicated that the subtype is going to be a bitmap. Obviously, because we are going to put icons into that. Now, do realize that there is never going to be a physical value in the physical table in this field. We are going to use this field to be able to put on a page, but we are going to fill it in code. Now, I also added that code. So I created a function fillStatusIcon, and I'm going to fill it when the status is released. So as the status is released, I'm going to get the icon from my icon table. I'm going to do the calc fields, obviously. I'm going to fill it. Now, the only thing that I need to do is add that field to the page. I've got my sales order list page where I added that field, the status icon, in the beginning. I always remove the caption, so I'd say show caption is no. And I just use that field. And then, an after get record, I fill the status icon by calling the function that I created. Now, the result is that I have a nice picture of all my orders that are actually ready to post. So this is how you can emphasize your data. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you next time.